holding today at the State House Conference Center, Abuja. This retreat is designed to prepare and sensitize cabinet members on the status of policies, programs, and projects of government, and the roadmap towards the delivery of its priority and next level agenda for 2019 to 2023. It will also provide opportunity to deepen the understanding of participants on best practices in conducting government business. Other specific objectives include: one, discussion on the critical enablers to success, such as collaboration with other arms of government; two, tracking and monitoring as the basis of performance management; and three, ensure all members are fully aware of essential government procedures, such as procurement, Federal Executive Council processes, and the role of the permanent secretaries in the ministries, departments, and agencies. Let me, on behalf of the ministers designate and other appointees, use this opportunity to formally thank His Excellency President Muhammadu Buhari for finding us worthy to serve the nation in different capacities at this critical period of our national existence. This call to service requires all of us to fully share in the President's vision and agenda for our country. As members of the President's team, it behoves on us to join him in providing the leadership required to develop Nigeria and lift the bulk of its people out of poverty. This presidential retreat is intended to further prepare us to be able to share in this vision and sense of purpose. Let me quickly reiterate that as ministers of the Federal Republic, you will be required to walk to the high standards of integrity, discipline, and dedication that have been set by the President in his long career in the service of the country. I would also like to remind you that of all the functions you will be called upon to perform as minister, none is more important than to help the President deliver the policies, programs, and projects required to move the nation to the next level. As the President said, our legacy will lie in how much we are able to deliver on this front, not on how much patronage we extend to close associates and supporters. As you are aware, the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria 1999, as amended, describes the Federal Executive Council as the principal organ for making policy decisions in the country. Indeed, Section 148, Subsection 1 and 2, A to C, explicitly specifies the responsibilities of the Federal Executive Council. It also stipulates that the President shall hold regular meetings with the Vice President and all the ministers of the government of the Federation for the purposes of: one, determining the general direction of domestic and foreign policies of the government of the Federation; two, coordinating the activities of the President, the Vice President, and the ministers of the government of the Federation in the discharge of their executive responsibilities; and three, advising the President generally in the discharge of his executive functions with respect to which he is required by the Constitution to seek the advice or act on the recommendation of any other person or body. It is therefore clear that the activities of ministers is a constitutional responsibility which requires focus on policy decisions, implementation, and coordination. You also have a leading role in your ministry in formulating and implementing and tracking policies, programs, projects, and communicating the impacts. It is equally important that you keep the focus on this core function of your offices, as this is where your role has the greatest significance for the President and the public. Distinguished participants, let me remind us that the task of governance requires patience, dedication, and total commitment to the social contract that we have entered with the Nigerian people, especially in realization of the yearnings for quick delivery of the dividends of democracy to the people. Most of the critical work you will do will not be seen by the public. Endless hours spent preparing and reviewing memoranda, obtaining and understanding the information and data on issues, analyzing the various dimensions and policy options, ensuring that budgets and expenditure are credible and accountable, extensively engaging with the poor and vulnerable segments of our political constituencies outside the glare of the press, among others. These are some of the activities that might not be seen or appreciated by the public, yet they tend to have the greatest consequences for what gets appreciated by the public. Hence, I would suggest that you take time to do this well, knowing that the results would eventually manifest and be appreciated by the citizens. As ministers, it is vital that the result of all our work connect to the aspirations of the people. This retreat is aimed at preparing us for the success that I know we are all committed to achieving. Although we acknowledge that we might not be able to cover everything that needs to be addressed, we have provided a complete reference document to serve as quick reference in the discharge of your ministerial duties. I urge you to go through and keep to hand as appropriate. I am looking forward with my team from the Cabinet Affairs Office of the Office of the Secretary to the Government to working together over these next 2 days with all of you. I encourage you to participate actively in all the sessions of the retreat, to ask questions, contribute your perspective, and also think critically about what you hear at this retreat and how it will shape the way we would work over the next 4 years. At this juncture, Your Excellency, I want to thank you for giving us the opportunity to shoulder the responsibility of preparing your team that would help you and assist you to deliver on your promises to the Nigerian people. And I thank all of you for coming. I thank particularly our resource persons, and I wish each and every one of us a very fruitful discussion in the course of this next 2 weeks. Thank you, and God bless you.